The theme we've chosen this year as Kampala Archdiocese goes as follows. Like the Uganda Martyrs, filled with faith, hope and charity, we shall overcome. We have also published a booklet concerning this pilgrimage, in which you find whatever concerns the lives of our Uganda Martyrs and also the historical background of this place. When you read and also meditate upon the lives of the martyrs, you really see that they were simple people. But because of their strong faith, hope and love in God, they were able to conquer the challenges that we're facing. As I begin my reflection, I would like you to join me in reciting the following prayer. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son. So we are here to glorify God the Father for the gift of faith, hope and love that he gave to our martyrs. And also to pray that we too follow the example and strengthen our faith, hope and charity. Before I proceed, allow me welcome all of you who are participating in this Holy Mass. Those present with me here, the fathers behind me here, the religious, and the laity gathered here. And all those who are participating from your various places via the Mass media. You are all most welcome, feel at home, and filled with faith, hope and love, let us celebrate this year's pilgrimage to the Uganda Martyrs. As you are aware, today is a very big and important day in the life of the entire Church. Today, together with the Universal Church, we honor the Uganda Martyrs. And these Uganda Martyrs, according to history, they were the very first martyrs of sub-Saharan Africa and two witnesses of the Christian faith. We have a Catholic calendar which is called the Ordo and is followed throughout the Church in the world. And on the 3rd of June, it's written that today is an obligatory memorial of the Holy Martyrs of Uganda. So today, all over the world, every Mass that is being celebrated is in memory of the Uganda Martyrs. Isn't that great? So today, the whole focus on the whole world is nowhere else but here. So we thank the Lord who gave them that faith, hope, and love. We also thank the missionaries who planted the faith here. And then all of us who are dedicated to them. And please let us continue to pray to them, especially amidst the challenges that we are having today. The biggest challenge we have today we have now the pandemic of the coronavirus, which is spread all over the world. So let us pray through the intercession that God intervenes and protects us from this virus. We have also the challenge of peace, especially our brothers in the United States, as you've seen, are not spreading in other countries. Peace, peace, peace. So let us also pray for the peace, so that it may be restored. And also let us pray that we respond adequately to the after effects of these challenges. namely health, poverty, and our ignorance in many other things. So Ugandan matters have made us famous worldwide because they were filled with faith, hope, and love. And for that reason, they gave up their lives for the love of God. Their ancestors had faith, and we should be people of faith in imitation of the Uganda martyrs. Every year before we celebrate this feast, it is preceded by a novena. Usually it starts on the 25th of May and ends on the 2nd of June. In as far as the Archdiocese of Kampala is concerned, we started it on Ascension Sunday, the 24th of May, and it ended on the 1st of June. And I would like to thank all of you, starting with the team of Namugongo, for having organized this novena to pray through the intercession of the martyrs, seeking for the assistance of God in our various challenges. Although the novena is finished and we're also celebrating the feast, don't stop to pray through the intercession, because they are interceding for us in heaven, and they are our ancestors and love us, and would also like that you and I and all of us are able also to win the war and be able to enter heaven. During this novena, we've been meditating on one, two, or three matters. And these matters, in front, you saw the fathers in front of our procession, they were carrying the relics of the Uganda martyrs. So we have those of St. Charles Ruanga, Matia Malumba, and then also Gildo Irwa and Daudi Okello of Kulu, who all of them will remember because all of them are united with us in faith, hope, and love. So our theme, like the Uganda martyrs, filled with faith, hope, and love, we shall overcome. But what is faith? Faith is the foundation and the content of God's message found in the Bible. Maybe before I mention the following, just to remind you that usually this is a national pilgrimage, and the whole of Uganda and outside Uganda, we are here. But because of the pandemic, the bishop decided, following the guidance of the government, that we should not come this year due to the fear of the spread of the disease called COVID. Let us pray through the intercession that they intercede for us. Before they were canonized saints, there was also a pandemic in Uganda. Not a pandemic, actually, it was a plague. And many people, whoever contracted it, had to die. People were taken to, by then Rubaga had a hospital. Two sisters, white sisters, contracted the disease. And they also contracted the disease, and they were separated from the rest, just as people are doing now with those who have COVID pandemic. Then Bishop Misho asked the faithful of Ruaga Archdiocese by then to pray through the intercession of the Uganda martyrs so as to intervene. And indeed they did, and the two sisters were miraculously cured without any medicine. So Bishop Misho sent the message to Rome, and Rome said, fine, Let us also send an independent medical doctor to verify. And they sent a Muslim called Ahmad from Egypt, who also verified that this sister had been cured miraculously. And after that report, the Pope decided to canonize them in October. When they were canonized, one of the guests in the front row was no other than this Muslim, Dr. Ahmad, who had sent this report. One of his grandsons is working in Kampala. He's a Muslim. He told me, "I love the Catholic Church." I told him, "Why?" "They took my grandfather to Rome to do what? To be present at the canonization of the Uganda Martyrs, because he verified the miracle which they made." So, my dear brothers, let us also fervently pray to the martyrs that this pandemic, you know, gets a solution. Then in Masaka, there is a gentleman called Evocato Kalema, who was born terribly lame and not walk. He also prayed the novena of the Uganda Martyrs, and he was able to recover and raise walking. I wanted to bring him today, but because of the problems of traveling, he could not come. He loves the martyrs. He also comes here to thank them. So, dear brothers and sisters, the Uganda martyrs are a reality. They are in heaven, and they can always intercede for us, provided we too have strong faith, hope, you know, and love. We are now living in a time when we can't access our churches to fellowship and also pray together. Not because we are persecuted, but because of health considerations, as you are aware, all over the world. It's now time for us to strengthen the domestic church after the example of the martyrs of the early church. So, now many of you are attending this Mass in your respective homes. Let us strengthen that domestic church and by so doing, become stronger in faith. The Uganda Martyrs teach us to have and nourish our faith with the Word of God. They also teach us to remain firm in faith, despite the fact that we cannot physically access our places of worship and our spiritual leaders. When the missionaries fled to exile in Tanzania, when they came back to Uganda, they were surprised to find that there were more converts to Christianity than when they left, and the church had become stronger. Why? Because of the domestic church and because of the Uganda martyrs who evangelized these people. So, dear brothers and sisters, wherever you are, and those who are here listening to me, let us strengthen our domestic church, praying every day, not only because of the pandemic, having morning prayers, evening prayers, and also able to attend and follow Holy Mass physically if you can, after we shall be allowed to join, or in your respective homes, listening to our respective radios, Radio Maria, and Father Serumaka, who is the director, is also here, and then also Radio Sapientia. So we need faith, and we have it since our baptism, so we only need to strengthen it. Then what is hope? Hope is the attitude and focus which you put on a particular matter or situation. The Uganda martyrs were to march happily to Namugongo to their death because they had hope in everlasting life. And that's why even when they were burning, they were not shouting or reacting, but praying, and even praying for those who killed them. They knew heaven was awaiting them, and they were filled with that Christian hope. Christian hope does not disappoint. It makes us train for greater things than the things we see now. One who has hope does not despair, even amongst the challenges. A heart that is filled with hope is convinced that despite the fact that evil may seem to be victorious for a moment, it can never and will never have the last word. So let us have that hope in God, and that attitude and focus which reminds us of our baptism and also of our Christian obligations. Then what's love? Love is charity. And whenever I talk of love, it's an action. When both faith and hope are in line, then action follows. So what happens to the matters? They are taught about the love of God. They are taught about God's goodness and what he expects of us, and even what he demands of us, as described in the Ten Commandments. So what do? They follow. They put that in action. And that's why they also displayed at the moment of their killing, they prayed even for the executioners. They didn't condemn them or abuse them. They prayed for the king who ordered them to be killed. Because even at that moment, they dared to love. And this reminds me of Jesus when he was on the cross. He forgave those who killed him when he said, as we read in Luke 23:34, Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. That is indeed action. Love in action. The current pandemic of COVID throws a challenge to us as believers. In the current social situation of this social distancing and the scarcity of resources, there is a strong temptation to retreat into selfishness, individualism, and also self-centeredness. There is also a temptation to develop a logic of the law of the jungle, which means survival for the fittest, which is against the Christian virtue of charity. The world matters teach us that moments of crisis and challenges should increase our acts of charity, our acts of love, and not to reduce or destroy them. As we reflect on the readings that we have had, we also remember and honor the Uganda martyrs. We are called to renew our faith, hope, and love on a daily basis. The readings we have just heard call us for renewal, taking the Uganda martyrs as our models. How do we renew ourselves? As I said earlier on, by feeding our faith and in our present circumstances through our families. And I encourage all our families, each family, to own a Bible. Not to be put in the shelf, but to read it on a daily basis. Fortunately, in as far as we are concerned as the Catholics, every day of the year, their readings were invited to meditate on. And all those readings invite us for renewal. And those are the readings which are read every morning or evening at Mass. So let us read them, meditate on them, and as a family. I also invite the families that should learn what the Church teaches as narrated in the Catholic Catechism. Each family should have a Bible. You should also have a Catholic Catechism. And that's where the Church guides us in as far as our renewal is concerned, and to know what is expected of us. First reading came from the Book of Wisdom. Nandibadde mukulaba kw'abantu babonaabona ne bubajjudde essuubi ery'obutaddayo kufa. Ennaku ziringa ziwedde bajja kugabana ku birungi bingi kubanga katonda abagezeseza nalaba ngabamusanide mbola kwa abantu baloza nti bawedde ne bazikirira levda kati emyaka kisonji kumwasatu kasokedde bafa na ye batu wujja batu sindika ne moyo wa katonda okulaba nti kyo kibakirize lecha batu sa kuwanguzi nafe tukifuna yesonga lwaki bangi abandi akadde okubeera wano olwaleero kwe bajja wano bafuna emikisa oluusi mpitako eno nyentera okusanga abantu ababazze okulamaga nga bazze kwebaza tize nasaba abajulizi ne bamponya mu kino nakiri nakiri awo nno bakkiriza bannange tubaagale ate tumanye nti bajja kutuusa ku buwanguzi. Second reading evudde in the letter of the Romans, chapter 8, verse 31 to 38. The words of St. Paul should remain in our minds. Obakatonda ali ku ludda lwa fe, ani anatwesimbako, mulaba okukkiriza okwo. Awo nno tusigale ku bintu ebituufu, ate obutagaana kye twalaganya Omukama nga tubatizibwa. Era Paulo atugambye, tulaba n'omwana wennyini temubalirira n'amwayo okubeera ffe ffenna ng'oyo amutuwadde byonna yalema atya okubituweerako. Awo nno Katonda oyo ali ku ludda lwaffe naffe kye tusigazze okukola nga tujjukira abajulizi ba Uganda si kirala wabula naffe okubeera ludda lwa Katonda. Tumanya tutya oludda lwa Katonda? Nga tumanya byatuyigiriza Ebayibuli gye mbagambye ye katikisi mu gye mbagambye tubeere nga tumumanya. So it is this giving of his only child for our sake that affirms God's love for us. So who then will separate us from the love of Christ? We can go through all kinds of afflictions, hardships and tribulations, as it said by St. Paul. Now we're also going according in the challenge of COVID-19. We are having floods, we are having locusts, all inclusive, but these should not separate us from Christ. Let us ask him to assist us so as to overcome them. The gospel, as we have heard, talks about, you know, planting a seed and produces lots of fruit. One of the early fathers of the Catholic Church was called Tertullian. Once he said that the blood of the martyrs is indeed the seed of Christianity, which is very true indeed. St. Charles Lwanga's blood fell here. For those who may not know, just below this altar, that's where St. Charles Lwanga, you know, was killed. And their story is just amazing. And because of that, can you imagine that three reigning popes have been able to come to this place? Pope Paul the Sixth, Pope John Paul the Second, both of them now are saints, and then recently Pope, you know, Francis. So let the seed, that which was sown here, continue to grow, and will grow where? In us, all believers. So the death of our martyrs is comparable to the seed of life buried in the earth. The seed dies in order to multiply itself. Some time back, Pope Francis said the following, that the church grows thanks to the blood of the martyrs. And this is the beauty of martyrdom, he said. If we look at the growth of the church here, it has grown because of the martyrs. They are part of us and they are praying for us. So the blood of the Uganda martyrs became the seed of the church in Uganda, and it is the reason that why every 3rd of June we gather here in this place for a pilgrimage to honor the martyrs. One day somebody asked me a question, why did they choose the 3rd of June? For your information, it's because that a number of martyrs, I think the biggest number, died on this day. Starting with Luanga here, and the others were martyred at the Church of Uganda's shrine. And if I'm not mistaken, there are 13 in number out of the, 22 that were killed. So we should be proud of them, and also share the little we know about them so that we keep ourselves informed and also share with the others the richness of our faith. So brothers and sisters in Christ, having heard and seen the faith of St. Paul, the apostles, the courage and faith of the Holy Martyrs of Uganda, we are all called to examine our way of life and our faith. Let us all reorientate our lives full of faith, hope, and love, so that from now on, we live no longer for the purpose of attaining our own selfish desires, but rather to glorify God with every single action. So let us emulate the example of the Uganda martyrs in our day-to-day lives, standing up for what we believe in, truth, justice, and love, and concern for one another. We pray through their intercession for more faith in God, for more hope in God, and also for more love in God and love of others. Let us continue our Mass, thank the good Lord for his goodness to us, and also to pray that our faith, hope, and love are strengthened more and more. The Lord be with you.